So here's a question for you. How did 1960s Britain drop its suicide rate by a third by accident? Back in the first half of the 20th century, Britain used a lot of coal gas for cooking and heating. But when it was discovered that natural gas was safe and economical to transport over long distances, and when we discovered huge natural gas reserves off our coast, we rushed to switch over, and use of coal gas was completely phased out by the mid-70s. This had a bizarre and unlooked for positive side effect: a significant drop in Britain's suicide rate. Wait, what? Coal gas is 10% carbon monoxide, which is very bad for you to breathe. If you do inhale it, you're unconscious in under a minute and dead in under 5. And a lot of people used gas in their ovens, so yeah, accidents and indeed suicides by that method were not uncommon. Natural gas, on the other hand, is a simple asphyxiant which has ethyl mercaptan or methyl mercaptan added so you can smell a leak, and thus stinks really bad. And frankly, it's more likely to blow up than actually asphyxiate you, and so it is a terrible suicide method. Now, you would think that the unavailability of coal gas would mean that suicidal people would just choose some other method to end their lives, but by and large, you would be wrong. See the grey line with the little X's? Death by coal gas induced carbon monoxide poisoning in the vast majority of cases. And see that massive drop starting in the early to mid 60s? And I had to redraw this one because the original is hard to see, but see the red lines in the top left of both graphs? Poisoning by gases in domestic use. That is quite a drop, right? Yes, but Jill, I hear you say. Look at the rise in the other kinds of suicides. Surely suicidal people will just find another way. Well, some will, yes, but take a look at the overall suicide rates for the same period. Again, see that massive drop? That drop of about a third? During the time period when we switched over from coal gas to natural gas? Or again, on this graph, which covers a longer time period, you can see it again. Turns out taking away a convenient method of suicide leads to fewer suicides. Hooray! And once you know about this, you can use it intentionally. In 1998 in the UK, shops were restricted from selling more than one packet of certain kinds of painkiller, and were also limited in the number of tablets that could be sold in one packet. You could still buy larger packets if you had a condition which required them, but you had to get them from an actual pharmacist, not from the supermarket. We don't think this will do any good, some people said, since people can just go to more than one shop. But 3 years later, the number of deaths from paracetamol poisoning decreased by 21%, and the number of deaths from salicylates by 48%. Liver transplant rates after paracetamol poisoning were reduced by 66%, and the rate of non-fatal self-poisoning with paracetamol in any form decreased by 11%. When it comes to suicide, barriers which may seem insignificant to the outside observer, like having to go to more than one shop, can save lives. And while it's obviously really important to tackle the root causes of suicide, seemingly small interventions that make it just that little bit harder to kill yourself on impulse really do make a difference. Strange but true, people. Strange but true.